Well, Black designers and brands are having more than a moment. From Telfar Clemens to Laquan Smith, these brilliant minds are shining in an industry that has long struggled with diversity. So who's got next? And what does it take to succeed in a fashion world that isn't always for us or by us? Here to break it all down is celebrated author, speaker, and the CEO of Fashion Bomb Daily, Claire Sulmers. Claire, thanks for joining theGrio Weekly.
Thank you so much for having me.
Of course. So Claire, let's jump right into it. We know that the mainstream fashion industry has often struggled with diversity, but it seems like Black designers and brands are getting a lot of recognition right now. What do you think is the reason for this? And should we be excited about what's actually happening?
Well, I do think that the Black Lives Matter movement, the untimely and unfortunate passings of George Floyd really kind of put racial issues and issues of civil unrest at the forefront of all of our minds. And we were forced to take a look at every industry, particularly the fashion industry. Now, issues of diversity has been one that Fashion Bomb Daily has been championing since 2006. We've always asked Vogue, why don't you have Black models or Black celebrities on your cover? Where's the diversity in terms of models on the runway, behind the scenes and on the scenes? But I really think Black Lives Matter and that whole movement for the galvanize the country and galvanize the fashion industry to take a look at their diversity practices and start to think, how can we be the change that we want to see in the world? So we started to see people like Anna Wintour say, okay, I haven't been as much of an advocate for Black designers and Black talent, and we're seeing more of a push towards that. But I also think now with social media, which Fashion Bomb Daily has undoubtedly benefited from, we see consumers having more of a voice and demanding more representation, demanding us showing brands with people who look and represent them, and us just having a more holistic view towards what it means to be a citizen of the world. We can no longer turn a blind eye or act as if people of color are invisible or haven't set trends or created trends in the fashion industry. And so the time is long overdue and the time is now.
For sure. We definitely set the trends. We are the culture and a lot of what we do, you know, people end up mimicking or creating their own version. But that doesn't stop our creativity. And to your point, Laquan Smith, his brand reported an 87% increase in sales since 2020, which we know was a key year for Black Lives Matter. My next question to you is about how we maintain that energy, right? So as people maybe move on and start to talk about other issues, how do we ensure that we're supporting these Black designers and brands so they have longevity?
Well, I think it's important for platforms like theGrio and also Fashion Bomb Daily to continue to hold consumers' feet to the fire, because at the end of the day, it's up to the consumer and what they want. And thankfully, Black Lives Matter, it raised a lot of awareness towards this issue. But it's interesting. I was just having lunch with Carl Kanai, who is a legendary fashion designer, one of the first who really put his feet down and created a movement in terms of urban fashion and Black fashion. And he hypothesized that hip hop is the driving force of the culture and fashion. And when he first started, they were wearing Carl Kanai and they were shouting out Carl Kanai. And now they're more so shouting out Louis Vuitton and a lot of European brands. So I think it's important for our leaders and our true influencers in our culture to really get behind this. Every celebrity, like the Golden Globes, for example, where just last night, if Black celebrities or celebrities in general made it so that every single time they stepped outside on the red carpet, when they have an opportunity to support these designers, I think that that can keep it going.
I love that idea of using your power, right? Because we really, again, we set the tone. So if we say it's cool, people do pay attention to what is shouted out in music. And I actually had a friend, shout out to my girl, Sophia, at her wedding, she asked everybody to wear Black designers for one of the wedding events. So there you go. That's how you set the trend. I have to ask you, Claire, you have such an inspirational story. You went to Harvard, shout out to the Crimson. Yes. You thought you would be a journalist, right? You went in thinking you'd be a journalist and then you broke into fashion on your own. What advice would you give for any young Black creative out there who is trying to pave their own way, but they feel overwhelmed by feeling like they're an outsider? What would you tell them about breaking in?
I would say to just be persistent and consistent. I did start out as an outsider, and I actually did start out as a journalist wanting to work specifically in fashion and just kept hearing no from traditional media. And so I decided to start a blog. And this was in 2006 when blogging was just starting to bubble up to the surface. And I just stuck to it. I used the resources that were available to me. First, it was Blogspot and then Instagram, all the free social media platforms, and just committed myself to excellence and being consistent every single day. We've updated Fashion Bond Daily every single day for the past 16 years. Well, now it's, we're going on 17 years now. I think with determination and just adherence to whatever mission you have in mind, continuing to evolve and diversify your offerings, I think that anything is possible. And I hope to that anybody who looks to my story can be inspired to know that they can do it too.
Claire Sulmers, thank you so much for being with us. And thank you for being a light and an example of what's possible when you do follow your heart and your passion.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Football injuries, they're considered to be just a part of the game, but what about the injuries that we can't see? Up next, we're talking about the mental and emotional scars that athletes deal with. Stay with us.